It's time to talk about the wise one, the person with the information and experience to share with future generations.
Hello and welcome, Eva here, master's level professional in the field of psychology and international book coach. And today we are talking about the character type of the sage. Now the sage is typically your truth seeker, your all-knowing individual, someone who has deep wisdom and insight into people, places, things, events, and the like. So now typically a sage is seen as more of a secondary character versus like a main character or a hero type, but their role is absolutely essential in solving critical problems that develop over the course of the plot. So famous sages you might know from movies, film, TV, and other forms of literature, books are, for example, Professor X in X-Men. Of course, he is the wise character, the one with the experience. There is Dumbledore in Harry Potter, for example. And then, of course, there's your Obi-Wan Kenobi or your Yoda type in the Star Wars franchise. So you're sort of getting the idea here. This is the wise old aunt, the wise old grandpa, or even the wizard in some cases. But this is the character that people go to in a fix, all right? So let's discuss some essential characteristics of the sage. So their viewpoint is that the truth will set you free. So this character spends significant portions of their time either reading or doing experiments or making observations about the human condition or any sort of project that might capture their attention. All right. Now, the goal of the sage is to share and disseminate information that they come across, right? And this point is to understand some truths about the world or even the entire universe and how it functions and operates and how the hero types can use this information to their advantage, right? So, the fear of the sage is misinformation, ignorance, foolhardiness, hard-headedness, and things of the like. So, when people are presented information and they don't take it, no. So, refusal to listen or a refusal to educate is a huge fear for the sage, a big no-no. So when discussing the character type of the sage, draw inspiration from people you might know. This might be a wise old aunt, a grandfather, or even a parent, or someone who's been around, seen a few things, and, you know, have something to offer by way of experience. And generally, these people cannot wait to share their information with you, whether that be in the form of a good old antidote or some kind of home remedy that they found that they put together in the past that might have worked for them, right? So this is your sage in everyday life. Now, so when discussing this character, talk about how they make you feel. How does it feel to go to the sage and humbly request their guidance, right? And how does the sage receive you? Do they invite you in with open arms and share their information willingly? Or does the sage, you know, maybe off point you simply in the right direction? Read this book or go watch this clip. There are some sages that will run off to the adventure with you, or that some that will just take you and go, gently guide you and give you sort of that good gentle push or encouragement. So these are things to consider when writing about the sage. So let's consider present day. Perhaps you might yourself even be a sage. If you are reflective, a scholar, a mentor, a philosopher, or even a guru of some sort, you yourself probably demonstrate some of the characteristics of a sage. So make sure you want to cover points such as how they explain things, how they reason about things, how do they treat facts, and how do they treat experiences, all right? And then you definitely also want to cover some of their weaknesses. And that might be their fear of making mistakes, right? So consider if you've ever got any bad or unuseful advice from somebody, right? And how did you feel? Are you shocked? Like, oh my goodness, the sage was wrong. And then in turn, how might that sage feel if they discover themselves that they had some sort of incorrect information, right? This often leads to that breakdown somewhere in their psyche or understanding when information that they have might be incorrect. This is a major fear of the sage, right? So hopefully this information has helped you. Feel free to reach out if you have any questions or need any help with the content creation process. I'd be happy to hear from you. And until next time, be happy and confident speakers and writers.